Sam Altman of OpenAI just posted a personal blog that was so wild I had to reread it several times. There is so much in here about the future of AI straight from the person who probably knows the most about it. So here's five crazy quotes that I think everyone needs to see. So number one is all about AGI, artificial general intelligence, and agents. So this is what he says, and I'm quoting here. "We are now confident that we know how to build AGI as we have traditionally understood it. We believe that in 2025, we may see the first AI agents join the workforce and materially change the output of companies," end quote. So let's break this down for a second. AGI means that AI systems can essentially match human level performance across most valuable work. So I'm not talking about just specialized tasks like writing code or image generation, but really the full range of what humans can do. And Sam Altman is saying that we're going to see this next year. This is just 2 years after ChatGPT basically went public. They're telling us that your new office coworker is going to have circuits instead of a brain. But here's where it gets even crazier. Quote number two on superintelligence. Here we go. "We are beginning to turn our aim beyond AGI to superintelligence in the true sense of the word. We love our current products, but we are here for the glorious future. With superintelligence, we can do anything else. Superintelligent tools could massively accelerate scientific discovery and innovation well beyond what we are capable of doing on our own, and in turn massively increase abundance and prosperity." And guys, this is the key difference. AGI matches human capabilities, but superintelligence surpasses them in every domain. We're talking about systems that can revolutionize scientific discovery and solve problems we can't even imagine right now. So the debate around this, and Sam Altman kind of approaches this a little bit, is not whether it can transform society, because of course it can. It's who benefits. And that's a conversation we needed to be having yesterday. Quote three, I think really shows that we're further along than we think. Here it is, in quotes. "The second birthday of ChatGPT was only a little over a month ago, and now we have transitioned into the next paradigm of models that can do complex reasoning," end quote. This, to me, is the biggest leap forward that people just don't know anything about. We're talking about AI that can actually reason through complex problems step by step. It's like figuring out logic puzzles or breaking down business strategies or whatever. So earlier models, the ChatGPT-4, et cetera, they can follow instructions unbelievably well. These new ones, O3, these can sort of think through things systematically, essentially, right? And they're doing it, this is important, they're doing it with less computing power, less cost to run. This can help on the energy crisis and everything else. These things are getting cheaper and more efficient. This is a colossal step forward. It's going to transform both what AI can do and essentially how efficiently we're going to be building these things. Fourth quote. This is where we're sort of talking about how unprecedented this is. Here it goes. "The launch of ChatGPT kicked off a growth curve unlike anything we've ever seen in our company, in our industry, in our world broadly," end quote. Okay. Think about that for a second. This means in just 2 years, OpenAI went from this pretty obscure research lab to creating this product that's so revolutionary that it became the default term for AI, right? We say, oh, use ChatGPT. It outpaced these Googles and Apples and Microsoft, these tech giants who had massive head starts. Finally, then the fifth quote here is, OpenAI is telling us that this is not your normal company. So this is what Sam writes in quotes. "A little over a year ago on one particular Friday, the main thing that had gone wrong on that day," because he was talking about things that had gone wrong on days, "was that I got fired by surprise on a video call. And then right after that, right after we hung up, the board published a blog post about it," end quote. You remember that? That was nuts. But here's what's amazing. OpenAI had created such a unique culture that basically all 700 employees threatened to walk out unless Sam Altman was reinstated. A lot of companies like that, because I do not. Here's what we know. OpenAI, they're not just another tech company, right? They're racing toward AGI. They're racing toward superintelligence. I don't know if they're going to be the first ones. There's a lot of other companies working on this, Google and everybody else. But what we do know is that this is a transformational technology. Who's not going to benefit? Is this going to just help the rich? Is it going to help everybody? Are we going to be able to lift all the boats? What we need to know right now is that unless companies are helping you get educated or you're educating yourself, then this is going to be something that's going to help some people race ahead and some people not. This is the moment to differentiate. By the way, on that note, I do have a digital course, Generative AI for Professionals, that's now available to enterprise. Get your company to buy everybody this course. This is going to transform all of what we do, because this is all about behavior, not just about learning a new tech, or a new tool. Guys, this is critical. We are seeing that this is going to change everything. We have to get on this today.